Hello, and welcome to this video on creating flowcharts. As with many data visualizations, there are plenty of software options available to make these in, but today we're going to be using Microsoft PowerPoint. Before we get into making an example though, let's have a glance at these simple sketches. The first sketch on the left has just three points arranged in a linear sequence. Let's say, for example, we wanted to show steps on how to cook something. You could do the steps in a sequence like this. But sometimes processes repeat themselves, and so over on the right we have a circular flowchart as well. The scientific method, for example, has different stages but eventually cycles back to step one. So there's quite a bit of variety when it comes to flowcharts. There's a lot of different kinds. Let's go make an example. Okay, so we are in a fresh Microsoft PowerPoint presentation, and we're going to be making two flowcharts, actually. So the first one we're going to do is a rather linear one, and then we'll do a cyclical one. So for both, we're going to go up to the Insert tab. And under the Illustrations group, there's a Smart Art button. Click on that. And there's a lot of different options in here, but we're looking for the linear one first. So we're going to click on Process. And there's more formatting choices in here, and you can change it afterwards, too, if you want to play around and see what that looks like. But we're going to go with the basic chevron and click OK. All right, so that gives us our basic diagram to start with. There's just three boxes right here, or three bullet points here at the side in the text editor. But we can add more. And our example is going to be making a pizza. And I've actually already typed it out already so that we don't have to see me type. We control all and paste. And there we have our steps. So we can see from the chevron pattern, the kind of arrows here, that it goes from prepare dough to add sauce, add cheese, add toppings, and bake. Now I realize some people put these on in different orders, but we get the idea. Now, as I mentioned earlier, if you want to change the style after you've kind of made this up and put in your information, then you can change the layout up here. And that kind of auto-updates so you can see what that looks like. Let's do the circular one. And you can also change the colors. Let's go maybe with an orange. Okay, and that's all there is to it. These ones are pretty simple. As I said, let's do another one that's cyclical so that you can see what that looks like. It's going to basically be the same. But let's add a new slide. And again, we'll go up to Insert. And under Illustrations, we'll click on the Smart Art button. And instead of Process, this time we'll go down to Cycle. And more formatting options, which again you can change later. Let's go with this one here. It's got the little arrows in between the steps. And we'll click OK. Just like before, we've got the diagram here. This time it has five boxes to start with. You can edit it so that there's fewer or more of them. And in the text editor over here at the side, you can use that to enter in your information. And for our cyclical flowchart, let's do, for example, the research process. So again, I typed this out so you don't have to see me type. Okay, we're going to control all so that we've got everything in this box highlighted and paste. So we've got origin, planning and design, data gathering, data analysis, results, and reporting. And sort of like the pizza, these flowcharts represent kind of simplified versions of the things. A lot of the time, it's kind of shown to happen one stage after another. It can go in a slightly different order, or there can be some back and forth between the different stages before moving on to the next one. So in a minute here, I'll actually go over another example. It's kind of complicated. We're not going to make one of those today, but sometimes flowcharts can be used for decision making. And in that case, you want them to be highly customizable, and you can do that in Microsoft PowerPoint. So we'll get to that in just a second. But before we do that, let's go ahead and change the layout again like we did before so you can see a different version of it. Let's go maybe with this one, and we'll go ahead and change the color as well. We'll do a different color for each thing.
So I mentioned that sometimes flowcharts can be complicated. Here's an example of a decision tree, which is a type of flowchart, and this one shows the metadata rescue workflow for the article that's listed down there at the bottom. This is a workflow with a lot of steps and a lot of different paths depending on the circumstances. We can see here that there are routes for yes and no several times in this example. And you can actually make this type of flowchart in PowerPoint too, but not using the Smart Art like we just did. So in the Insert tab, right up here at the top, if we go down to Shapes, which is in the Illustrations group, then we can see that we have a lot of different line choices that we can use, straight or angular lines, and then we've got some curvy ones here as well. And there's also a category down here for flowchart shapes, and you can use those in concert with each other, kind of build your own flowchart. So there's a lot of flexibility with doing it that way. It's a bit more of a manual process, but you can highly customize it. I'm not going to make one of these today, but I did want to show you briefly that you can. All right, that wraps up this video. We've covered the basics on making flowcharts in Microsoft PowerPoint, and we've seen a couple different ways to do that. The version of PowerPoint you're using might mean that some of the features I showed are in different places, aren't available, or you might have extra features that you didn't see on my screen. But hopefully things should be about the same. Please reach out to the library if you have questions, and thanks for watching.